Yeah.
Give me 1 sec.
No problem. We'll wait
here. It does. Yeah. I agree. I'm saying a hockey.
Harder to study, and the morbid is not complete, but also in different order.
What is the order of the manuscript then? That's the main copy that we study.
Yeah, so the orders for the both getting and design to actually they start off with the abizari, the wrestling, the go into the dagger section and then go through the sword and sword defense sections as well as further going on with other equipment and of course that.
That picture is in three of the four copies. What is it?
So this is the signal page of that demonstrates us to us only six threads and for us that on it, showing us the directions of those threads that's supposed to be carried out, as well as it shows us the major elements of fencing, which you see be on the bottom, you have the elephant with the castle that which is for the Tudor, which is ability to stand up tall and strong, so we can sure that you're not toppled over. Well, then you have the line of the heart on it, which is audacia. The courage to do what you know, to use the things that you know. Above the head, there's a length, there's a compass, which the idea of measure and judgment is represented in this. And finally, there's a tiger with an arrow, which represents the speed of swiftness, which includes both physical and mental swiftness.
Can Stuart tell us which of those attributes is the most important?
Yes, the most important one is the line, because the idea is that if you don't use what you know, if you don't have the heart to use it, then what's the point?
Would you like to tell us anything more about Fiore and his works? The other master. What is his name?
Gerstel.
Please tell us about his life and his works.
So Gerstel lived much later. He's a 16th century fencing master. He wrote two works, The Paradoxes of Defense and Commentary on Paradoxes of Defense, in which he lays out the basics of fencing. Versus Fiore, whose works are more for advanced fencer who already knows the basics of fencing. So Gerstel has written this work based on his idea that England was inundated with foreign instructors of fencing who were not very good at it, and therefore he written a work to show exactly what's the basics that they need to be every fencer needs to know in order to conduct to be safe in the actual fight.
So what are the works that George Silver authored and what in them is important to us?
So the works are the paradox of defense and the commentary to that, and the major elements to us is the proper movement of the body, which is hand, body, foot, or feet, depending on the situation. The idea is that it's a movement in short time to ensure that you're presenting a threat before you present a target. As well as it talks about the grounds of the governance of the fight, which in the case of the governance, those are the judgment, the measure, and the twofold mind, which is the idea of when to present the attack and when to defend yourself. While the grounds are the time, place, distance, and judgment.
Tell us a little bit more about the twofold mind.
So the idea about twofold mind is that when you are fencing, you need to keep in mind that there's a possibility that your attack might not go as planned, therefore you need to prepare yourself to defend against the opponent at the same time, or if you are attacking, maybe it's not going to plan, you might be able to pursue your attack in a different fashion. So you need to keep in mind at all times not to be simply focused on just the one thing that you do.
The ground, judgment, distance, time, and place, like you said, is there a significance to the order? Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
So the grounds themselves is ideas that you're judging based on what on the distance between you and the opponent, the time that you have to do so, the place that you, how you're standing, how what kind of threat that you're presenting, what kind of threat the opponent's presenting, and the judgment is based on all those thought information you deciding on what your action should be. And then similarly from that, of course, the judgment and measure, which is again the distance from that, based on the judgment measure, you will decide how you act, which falls into the default mind.
Is there anything else about George Silver that you'd like to tell us?
No.
Alright. Colleagues, do you all have any questions about any of the topics of the law?
Yes, there's a goal to the judge, to the governors, to go to the police, to something in place. Can you describe to me what that place is?
Well, the places to be is a mindset that needs to be an advantageous place of advantageous agent.
I think you might have touched on it, but I don't
attributes that Fiore says are necessary for a good fighter.
So the H attributes are strength, speed, knowledge of advantageous strikes, knowledge of advantageous grapples, knowledge of binds, breaks, throws, and dislocations.
Please show us the footwork that we use in our on the salary system, and then afterwards show us the four post of the salary.
So the footwork that we use is this increasing step, passing step, metal bolter. There's a bolter started, turning in place, a good bolter, and a complete turn which could be done depending as necessary, as much concern or as little as possible. At the same time, the increasing step could go to the increasing step, or the passing step could be down first. And the guards for Zari are the iron gate, from Tali, Manga, and horse boot, which could be
down. Okay, can you please combine the footwork and the upper side full step if you throw? Let us see if you do it together.
Yep.
You see an opportunity to throw some strikes as you see fit.
Second one.
Okay, and now please show us all of those points again, and please complete them, with the exception of the arm break that we need to get in.
It's step away from the wall.
Yeah, you're Okay. Well, is there any questions about the sixth play?
Yes.
Yep.
I'm not sure if this might be just a difference in instruction when the opening move, what should your opponent be grabbing?
So he's grabbing onto the shoulder here. So there could be variations in the opponent can grab on anywhere, but that will change the outside slightly to play depending on the opening with my left hand. So it's a counting where so he's grabbing here, so to prevent the hand from slipping off, in that case I will.
You want to see it demonstrated from grabbing at the back of the head?
Yeah, back of the head, yes.
Now I will ask Duncan to engage in some light wrestling if you were not, and we would like to demonstrate all the things that you just showed up.
Get away from the wall.
Center.
Guard the fireplace. Mostly guards are there. Good. So, okay, last chance for questions on the other side section.
And is there anything else you would like to tell us again, or go over or repeat?
No.
Renat, do you have a water bottle handy?
Yes.
You should take a drink right now.
Okay, thank you, guys.
Considering our problems.
All right. The next subject in terms here is gender. There are three important pages which precede the dagger section in the beginning. One of them deals with the post of the dagger. Can you please show us all of the post of the dagger?
Yes. The dagger posters are arrogate, arrogate double, arrogate cross, and they can be performed with the dagger. So this is arrogate cross, arrogate double, arrogate.
Okay. Bastian, we're going to ask you. We're going to ask you to assist. I'm using Bastian as a target. Please demonstrate for us the strikes of the deck.
So I'm reconstruct, aiming for opening in the neck there to go into the vitals now. And then the strike. Again, I'm aiming for opening in there in the neck to go into the vitals to reversing. Which is opposite to Madrid. And I'm aiming for the neck there. And finally, a tiny strike. I aim to go into the belt and then through the spinal column going up.
Please do it again without commentary. All right, and lastly, there are four masters who can see the dead reception. Who are they?
Yeah, so the masters we have of the lizards, we have the master of bricks, the keys, and the frogs. So they are presented in a sequence. We believe that it's based on how they dress and how they look, that it's a sequence of how more sophisticated the play that needs to be performed is and how much more time you need to perform.
Okay, and why are they presented before the dagger section?
They are presented in such a way because the dagger section then lays out the ideas that we how we flow from one possible master to the other, depending on what that point of example.
Okay. Alright, Nasir is going to attack you with the four basic attacks. As we've demonstrated, we're going to present four basic attacks.
Sure. see the best thing to throw if it hit it, if you can pull back with the left arm. For the throw, if it hit it, a best thing to throw if it hit it and pull back with the straight arm. And for the break, a best thing to throw if it hit it and push through. For reverse the attack action, put this arm resting on throw the attack and the stay action. For the break, best of the reverse the attack is a stay energy. For the key, best of the throw, reverse the attack and pull back with the bent arm. Start. Let's try again. And for the throw, best of the throw, reverse the attack is a stay energy. Okay, we have another counter, too. Alright. And finally, for Satani, we'll throw the Satani attack with the stay energy. That would be this arm. Then for the break, Bastion will throw the Satani attack with a push for energy. For the key, Bastion will throw the Satani attack and pull back to them with a bent arm. And for the throw, Bastion will throw the Satani attack and pull back low with a dagger.
Good. Now, of all the things you just demonstrated, is there anything you want to show us again or add to your talk there?
No.
Okay. Scholars, do you have any questions on anything we just did? Yes, please.
So, when you've been doing the particular piece, you've been stopping before the next half and the next half. If you want to continue those to an actual end where you actually get it right, it's helpful.
Thank you.
Yep, there are two types of condensed attacks.
Yes.
It's presented only one attack.
Yep. So the other one.
To demonstrate the attack and the defense will come from.
Yep. So the other one would be to go straight in through the neck and then it's not the same and the just are slightly different.
Great. All right, now Bastien, do not please mask up and then we're going to do some death kills.
It's a murder death kill. That's all.
Okay, go. Now we'll show it to us again with either one hand or two on the sword. Go around the pot once and across the line. This one, go very slow. You what you were doing.
Renat, if you were fencing him, would you be in the same distance? Let's see one where you think you'd want to hit him.
Size to defend itself against single time gravity. we'll cross as closer to the middle now with the swords as we do the connectors. In which case, I will step in, grab this blade, do the long one. Cut and kick him at the same time. Alternatively, if we cross in the middle, and we cut out with our crossing.
What's the difference? Why would you do that one and not cut it out? Like, what would be the
reason? Well, because it's available to me, but if I was to do, let's do the cut around section, but just stop where I was out doing around. In this case, I don't see how I'm going to cut now. I actually see this space is much easier for me to go around. Now, then in the previous situation, we were at this. See, at this place, which I can see from here from this side, so I'll have a build to cut down safely while he's going to this side.
Okay. Okay.
Now, also coming with a heavy blow, the as well as a villain strike or brother strike. That'll tie around. That's more incredible. I can't see the next situation. If Alex were to throw a Satani at my leg, I'll step out and keep him, but that's why I need more help, so start again. There he is, no problem.
He's lost a bit there.
So my idea is for me to avoid the engagement and to attack him. Yeah, I believe that's there's another one that I'm going to say. If you're across at the middle, not the middle, at the strong, I'll be immediately connected. The ability for me to actually deploy it and to get the joint.
Okay, so far you've demonstrated lots of things that you can do against a top.
Yep.
What about defenses against a cross?
Yes, so they'll do the exchange of cross. Alex will they'll do a cross against him. Now they'll pop a cross him. Alternatively, if Alex has a cross against me, I can beat it with him and cut up. If the sword is close enough to me, I can step on it.
Okay. Can you show all those again without commentary?
Sure.
You can tell how
yeah, so the pro-fidentic. Now defending against that. Let's cross to the middle. Cross to the end of the middle. Cross out the strong.
Can you do that again
yes.
In more convincing fashion? I want to see Alex kind of
aim for his don't aim for his little class.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, fine. Yes.
Do you know if there's any difference between
frontality defended. So I'm going to frontality defended because it's a special scalar strike.
As opposed to?
As opposed to the usual one where it's much, much more wider strike. Which allows me to easily deal with it.
You know, the manuscript is like the same over.
Now to move on to Stretto. Can you remind us what the Stretto section is about?
Yes, the Stretto section is about the reconstruction plane, situations where, let's say, for our cost, we send a story, so we were much further distance, and our team would be not mirrored but matched. And this is all this situation, I will not be able to, it's easy to move around my story around this, so therefore I need to do something to. Something else
to
which case
looks
some kind of formal connection.
Okay. Please show us all of the struggle plays
when you go. Okay. So, let's start in the middle. So, in this case, when I see Alex, it's a
basic. Stop us here before you go on, let me just say it right now. Will you show us the play, give us the commentary,
okay.
Do it, and then show it again with our commentary. That way, I won't have to make you repeat this.
Okay.
Okay. Go.
So I see the Alex's play face on this side, you can see it's much, much more to this end, so therefore I will do a summary of suppress him and stick him to the bomb. Alternatively, I can do so also with both my arms.
Why would you choose either one or the other?
Depending on distance, so this the distance I can enter, the cross border, I don't need to suppress that, I do not want to suppress with my arms. With both my arms, it's approximately there. The policy is more this side. Another 35 that I have is to hit away his hands and then cut down. I also can drop his hand, put his sword in the ground. If his hands are low, I can pick them up with my guard and then do a little key on the guards.
So we're now, can you demonstrate this with him again? Mm-hmm. And Alex, if you see him putting the mask on, actually not, if you see him uncovered, you should get that. Okay? Here we go.
Instead of just holding the sword out, and then
Renat,
can you demonstrate some of the plays?
Oh, I
Thank you.
So if you can give them the cut and not just leave the sword lying there for them, and then Renat demonstrates under your place.
This is all cuts are just in the scrap.
Well, actually, I completely missed going around the clock with the basic attack. So let's get to that. Please give him all the attacks around the clock, twice around. And you're going to make basic defenses against all of the attacks.
Okay. All right, around the clock. Start from the deck.
Yeah.
Follow ons?
No.
Next phase.
Questions or anything we covered so far. Okay? Did anything happen to that?
principle of the true fight?
The principle of true fight is to follow the grounds of governance and to follow the hand-body true motion to ensure that you are not presenting yourself as a target and not without being protected. So that way you always stay safe in the fight.
What is moving a hand-body foot? Let you move in. What if you move in reverse, foot body hand, what would you call that?
That would be the false time. So, well, basically the hand body foot motion is the true time. Any other basically interpretation of that would be the false time, because you're presenting a target before you present a weapon or before protecting yourself.
Can you do the difference against the seven crash with one hand?
Oh, yes.
This concludes this portion of the exam. We will break for 5 minutes or so to allow everyone who's fighting to get armored up and for the scholars to arrange themselves in well order. If we're not, please get enough water and pour yourself out so you can go. So.
Sport fencing is because it's not the synthetic material, like the tips, I would get more points for me because I'm going to pick up a lot in the scene. Because it's not the slip material like the sport fencing, it's the tips would carry me.
That's crazy.
I still do it anyway.
No, I just think it's crazy that they really gain the
strength. Yeah.
No, it is. It's more for you.
That's what I said.
It's kind of good.
literally hammered for like that.
And then, like, right after, like, there's roots just ready.
It's going to be a good spot for, like, community and stuff.
Yeah. It's like,
it's kind of hard to, like, the first time I came in there, I was like, what's that? Yeah.
Good hit.
Yes, really.
Next, Mike Carrington.
No.
Thank you. Good. Okay, we're going to take your last drink of water. Okay, next, Leander. The last scholar in the list, you get off. Thank you.
Yes, thank you.
Last pass. One more pass.
So we now have this vote. All go will fence until he decides you've had enough.
What am I doing?
You will call your own timing.
Oh, okay, all right, sure, very good, very good. Yes, yes, yes. How you doing? You okay?
Yeah, I'm good.
Okay, good. Nice! The scholar exam. The scholars will now meet to discuss the grading. Everyone will follow me, please.
Yeah.
Into the bathroom, everyone.
That's gonna be cool. I'm gonna get another mask. I was gonna say we should have kicked them out.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's there. He's there. One time.
try to go straight away. And I'm like, that's how you stay in line. That's how you keep it in line. You're very good at it. And whenever someone goes straight away, you punch them so hard that you're afraid of it.
No, I have some points.
It's not physical, it's also
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That comes up really hard. It can be a bit of a concussion, yeah. Like a mild concussion. Yeah.
Usually when people go to swimming with him, it's just like, oh, you got it. It's stressful.
Yeah, I wish, like, after Palmer's parents, they used to finish that.
I feel like we don't, in general, as a club, do Palmer's strengths very, very much justice to them. As opposed to really, you know, like,
yeah, but then that's the stuff that Dan's doing. So,
yeah. Which is fair. What are the people that are pretty mangled mass? About 6 hours a day, twice, two or three times a month.
Because I've heard that, and I'm like, I don't know what to expect. Are you coming to the
camping? No, I'm not coming.
You're not coming.
Is there a
camping? Yeah. Sarita? Are you coming to the camping thing? Okay.
Hi, I'm Graham.
I'm Savita.
Nice to meet you.
Same here.
All the way up there.
Yeah. Are you comfortable?
Yep.
It's a good spot.
You will enjoy. There's a lot of space.
Is there enough space? You guys want to head up there? I like the fan.
It's not wrong here. It's not hot.
Like, it's not the only person.
Maybe, yeah.
Like, I can feel like sweat, like, dripping down my back.
Yeah, you have a wash.
It's not really working.
This is wrong.
It's doing its best. It's good. Yeah.
Hey! Oh, yeah.
scholars. Well, why, what are you here for?
Another
question. Oh, no, no. You should be the first one.
Yeah, sure.
What is all the drink?
Yeah. I was contemplating whether to bring my car because the subway closure. I'm like, there's gonna be drinks after all. I want to get the sword off.
It's a new space.
Wear the jacket.
I just need a pair of ringlets.
There we go.
I just wore it on the subway. It is hot.
Are you talking about the
pigs? No.
There's a post,
yeah. has one book.
Yeah.
He voted on it.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I don't, other than Neander, I think he left a comment. I don't know who they would be.
Oh, really? Oh, that's weird. I didn't know that.
Same with you, right?
Because I could see when you put on an option, you can look at it. I can see who voted for what.
Oh,
maybe that's just a guy.
Yeah, that's what I heard about. I know only the end is there. Usually things get organized right at the last minute. So I need to start putting hats this weekend. I'm sure it's more than just Leander.
Leander
does.
How many of you are there so far?
How many of you are there? Five, six?
We'll get some more. Get some more.
Don't overstep.